Welcome to my channel, Patrick Cat's Place. I'm going to do a video of two items that I've received in the mail this week. I'm going to focus on these two because they're Christmas and this is the week of Christmas. The first is a book called Christmas Elvis, The Official Guide to the Holidays from the King of Rock and Roll. Now, I was looking for another book on Amazon about Elvis and Christmas, and I saw this one and I sent for it as well as the other one, and this was the first to arrive. And I've got to tell you, it's a great book. I'm going to move the camera around in a minute to show you, go through the whole book. But when I got it and unpacked it, I sat down at the kitchen table and I read it right through. It's just got some beautiful text. The photos are good, but it's more about the text. The chapters, Elvis's Christmas album, song by song. Elvis sings the wonderful world of Christmas, song by song. So they go through every song, the history of the details, the background singers, when it was recorded and so on, of Elvis' two Christmas albums. And then it's got Elvis's favourite Christmas songs, his own favourite Christmas songs, his Christmas memories, Christmas cards, holiday recipes, and gifts and Elvis. So it's a really comprehensive book and everything you want to know about Elvis and Christmas. The other thing, which you can hear in the background, is this CD set, If Every Day Was Like Christmas. Now this is the special collector's edition. I saw this on the Jamie and John's EAPSociety channel and I had to have it. It's such a buzz. You think that's, you know, it's you've got a lot of CDs? No, it's got one CD, which is just in this cover, the slip cover. And it's got a little booklet, As They Come, Elvis Presley, If Every Day Was Like Christmas, information about all the songs. And all the recording session information and so on, with a few photos. But the best thing about this is, and I'm going to go around the other side of the camera to do this because it's a bit hard to do in front of the camera, you can't really see what you're doing. It's a pop-up. It's three-dimensional Graceland pop-up. Isn't that the neatest thing you've ever seen? I just love it. That's the front, turn it around, and that's the back. I wanted to put it on the coffee table or my dining room table and just leave it up over the Christmas period, but it's a bit hard because it's, you know, pretty stiff cardboard, and to force it open like that, you'd have to weigh it down with something, and I haven't figured out how to do that. So in the meantime, it's just on the coffee table as it is. But yeah, really great, terrific songs. Okay, now the book itself, I'll take this here, pick this up, and we'll go through, flip through to the book. It's got some lovely text in it, stories about quotes from Elvis over the years, the interviews he's done and so on, about Christmas, how he feels about it. Talks about from the Ed Sullivan Show. Some of the pages are just graphics rather than photos, but there is a lot of photos. So Elvis's Christmas album, October 1957, the track list, and each song has probably at least two pages dedicated to it, the history of it. Christmas. And then between the songs, you've got these little things like what Christmas presents did Elvis buy for himself, the grounds, how they were decorated over the years, for Christmas, here comes Santa Claus, Elvis in the Army, Blue Christmas, Elvis when he was donating. He donated more than $50,000 to local Memphis charities every Christmas. That's a nice shot. And little article about thing. What Elvis said, they had a little Christmas party over Germany for the guys on the base. I had many of the boys here as possible to make it them feel at home around Christmas. We had a little Christmas party on New Year's Eve. We had another little party. Well, I bet it wasn't a little party. Now, this, I really love this. There'll Be Peace in the Valley. For all the songs, they talk about the background, who wrote them and how they were come to be written. And this really touched me. Peace in the Valley had World War II roots, as described by the songwriter Thomas Dorsey. Just before Hitler sent his war chariots into Western Europe, I was on a train going through southern Indiana on the way to Cincinnati, and the country seemed upset by this coming war. I passed through a valley on the train. Horses, cows and sheep were all grazing together in this little valley. A little brook was running through the valley, and up on the hill I could see where the water was falling from. Everything seemed so peaceful with all the animals down there grazing together. It made me wonder, what's the matter with humanity? What's the matter with mankind? Why can't man live in peace like the animals down there? Dorsey began scribbling the words to his songs, taking inspiration from the spiritual standard Walk Through the Valley of Peace and the Old Testament. I just love that write-up. I think that was beautiful. This particular EP, I haven't got the EP, of course I've got all the songs on it, but I reckon if I had it, it would have been worn out by now, because it's got probably four of my very favourite of Elvis' songs. Peace in the Valley, It Is No Secret, I Believe, and Take My Hand, Precious Lord. And so Elvis loved the song. During the sessions he said, it's easy, I could sing this song all day. Well, Elvis, I could listen to you sing it all day. I Believe, which is another favourite. Love that song. And then there's information about songs, novelty songs that were recorded by other artists about Elvis. And quite often, quite a lot of them were related to Christmas. I want it to be Christmas with Elvis. I want Elvis for Christmas. I don't want a bunny, I just want Elvis. Take My Hand, Precious Lord. The Secret What God Can Do. And then of course the Christmas decorations, so the first lot of Christmas decorations. Information about that. Oh, there they are. And that's special again, a graphic illustration rather than a photo. Love that. That's my tattoo is based on that. You know, I wish I'd done my tattoo in colour, but it's a bit hard on skin. I know they can, but it wouldn't be quite as good. I think the black and white is adequate on somebody's skin. Photos. Love that photo too. All the photos that were taken of that 68 special on this black leather, which is brilliant. Oh, not only the black leather, everything. Sings the wonderful Christmas, World of Christmas LP, song by song. That's the LP cover. October 1971. And the track listing. A pensive photo. Photos that are in here is really good. There's a really cute one of him and Lisa. Mama Like the Roses. I didn't know that song was written specifically for Elvis. It's great what you find out in some of these books. Drawing. Elvis's favourite Christmas songs written, sung by other people. Yeah, it was his Christmas memory. Again, more quotes from Elvis and the Colonel by May Mann in 1975. Fireworks at Graceland. Oh, always amuses me when I see photos of, or pictures of any artist really reading magazines about themselves. What would it feel like? I can't imagine picking up a magazine or a book and it's just about me. Not Elvis, am I? Okay. Some of the Christmas cards that he and the Colonel put out. Okay, holiday recipes for the King of Rock and Roll. These are just cookies. Blue Christmas pistachio dessert. And I don't know whether they were actually made at Graceland by Elvis's cooks. Possibly not. Squares, I think he's just, the author's just pulled some recipes together and just given them sort of Christmassy names. Although Bee's Knees, that's a well-known cocktail. Nice photo of Graceland lit up. I didn't realise that was December the 21st, 1970. So yeah, that was pretty close to Christmas when that happened. Gifts at Elvis. Some of the gifts that he gave his loved ones, his friends. And what do you buy for an international superstar who has everything? Some of the gifts that people gave Elvis. And a little bit down here about what his fans used to send him. Clothes, of course, billfolds, keychains, cufflinks, neckties, shaving lotion, God. Sweaters, caps, socks, so on. Yeah, and then a bibliography, reference to the sources that the authors used to write this book. So, yeah. Elvis and the Colonel again. Great book. Lovely book, in fact. I would recommend it if you see it around. Like I said, it's only been in the last couple of years published, so enjoy. Thanks for watching.